Sisense makes it really easy to analyze data through visualizations, or widgets. So to add a new widget to a new dashboard, we need to start with the data. I simply click on Select Data and am presented with a data model, with all its tables, fields, and the formulas that are contained within it. If I scroll down, you see I have a table here called Commerce, with all its fields. Similarly, I have another table over here called Brands and all of its fields. To get started, I need to select a field that I want to work with. So I can start typing the name here, and all the matching fields will come up. Once I have a field I want to use for analysis, I can click on Sum, and it will calculate the sum on that field. Or, if I click on More, it will open up additional menu options with additional calculations and filters that I can apply to that field. For now, let's keep it simple. I'm going to select this field and perform the sum of costs. This is the default visualization. And on the left, I can choose how I want the data to appear in the widget. What's important to note is that as I add fields of different types, different options will open up to me to choose how I want to visualize and analyze that data. So I'm going to go ahead and add more data. In this case, I'm choosing the country field. And because it's a text field and not a numeric field, there are slightly different options. So I can either perform a unique count, or I can select all the items, or I can use a filter. So in this case, I'm going to select all the countries. And you can now see that the preview has been updated. I have a pivot table now that lists the country and the costs have been broken down per country. In addition, on the left-hand side, I have other widgets to visualize the data. So if I click on pie, I'm getting this data presented as a pie chart. I can also add additional fields as I need for my analysis. I can also click on a particular field over here that I'm using, and another menu opens up. So in this case, I can change the calculation. So if I want to do a count instead of a sum, there's also quick functions available. We discuss these in later videos, but we can do QuickTime functions, and I can use various formatting options as well. Lastly, to the left over here, I have advanced configurations. Clicking on that will open an additional window, and I'll be able to format this particular widget further. Once I'm happy with my widget, I simply click Create, and it's placed on the dashboard. I can add as many widgets as I need for my analysis. So I can go ahead on the top, click Widget, and the widget window will open up again, and I can repeat this process. In addition, note that by default, the tables and fields are taken from the data model you selected, but you can select to base your widget on a different data model. As you can see, I now see different tables and fields. This is useful if you want to include your dashboards both widgets based on ElasticCube data models and live data models. These are models where the data is refreshed in near real time. For more details about live, see our video connecting to live data. So you can see that creating widgets is a very simple, iterative process. You need to focus on the data, and Sisense will suggest the appropriate visualization, so you can very quickly get a very rich and insightful dashboard. For more information, see our online documentation.